The HST was the largest tax policy change in BC's history. Leading the change to this progressive new tax was a quiet, unassuming woman who had recently arrived from Ontario.
Think about the complexity of unwinding the old PST system and making sure that the transition is as smooth as possible as we go into the HST system. Elizabeth did it all with poise, with grace, with professionalism.
Elizabeth is one of the strongest policy advisor and policy expert that I have ever worked with. She's an exceptional strategic thinker.
Our job here in Tax Policy Branch is to provide advice to the Minister of Finance. We do research and analysis into the various types of taxes. We constantly look at what is the economic impact of the options, what is the revenue impact, how is it going to affect BC businesses and stakeholders in the province, how is it going to impact the public.
Being a really good policy advisor to a deputy minister or to a minister of finance is a very rare, very unique attribute. She can stand back and she can look at the forest through the trees.
I work with a really great group of people here, and that's important because I have to be able to trust them completely. They're experts in what they do.
And then after putting all her heart and soul into that transition, which I know it must have averaged out to many, many, many hundreds of hours, to go and unwind it all and transition it back into the PST system. Elizabeth really set us a gold standard for dedication in the public service.
We were really starting from scratch and having to create a whole new tax act to go back. Yes, we're re-implementing it, but a lot of work has to be done to reenact the old act. It's from 1948. It doesn't work well in a modern world, so we're working to kind of improve that.
She takes great pride in the work that she does. It's very important to her that she provide the best quality and the most comprehensive advice. In my view, she has incredible leadership skills when it comes to being a public policy expert and a public policy advisor. I think she could eventually be one of the top public policy advisors in the BC government.